Motor control blues got you down. Don't worry, we've all been there. For a lot of today's medical and industrial designs, stepper motor control has gotten a lot more complicated. Sure, modern motors are vastly better than the old ones, but it's almost like if someone gives you a jet. Sure, it's way faster than your old car, but now you have to learn how to fly a jet. So folks, let's turn that motor control frown upside down. Because I might just have the perfect panacea to make those motor control blues fade away for good. Hi, I'm Amelia Dalton, host of Chalk Talk. We all want a stepper motor control solution that is low cost, includes the ability for precise control and high torque, and that's not too difficult to use, right? If none of those apply to you, well then, never mind. But for a lot of us, those factors can be crucial to the success of our next design. In today's Chalk Talk, I sit down with Lars Jaskulski and chat about Trinamic's stepper motor solutions. We talk about the benefits of stepper motors, what micro-stepping is all about, and the value of load measurement in motor control designs. All right, let's get stepping. And before we get started, don't forget to click that link. There you can find even more information about this topic from Trinamic. Okay, so we're talking about motor control today and specifically how Trinamic's technologies work in this space. But before we get into the details, Lars, why should I use a stepper motor in my next design?
Yes, so stepper motors are motors that can be easily integrated into systems that need any kind of motion in the system. It's ideal to keep the cost down by enabling, at the same time, precise motor control. So with a stepper motor, you get a very high torque output in relation to its size when comparing it to other motor types, and enables maintenance-free systems by its high durability. So maintenance level is very low. So that's kind of the benefits that you get when using a stepper motor.
Fantastic. Now, can we walk through how a stepper motor works?
Sure. So on this slide, we see like a basic operation of a motor. It's very simplified. You can see it on the right, this visualization where we see in the middle the rotor, which is typically a permanent magnet. And then we see two coils. One is oriented to top to bottom and the other one from left to right. And by energizing the coils in different orientations, we can see that the rotor in the middle is changing its position. In this case, it's a full step mode. So in total, we get four possible rotor positions. What we see here is that a stepper motor is nothing else than a spring mass system. So on the left side, you can see this spring with a mass on the bottom. And in full step mode, you can see that by jumping into each position, it generates oscillation. And comparing it to the right one, which is a half-step mode where we divide the stepper control into even more positions, which I explain on the right side, you see that the oscillation is quite reduced. So it's not that drastic anymore than comparing it to the full-step oscillation. And what is going on is what you see on the top right, where the first half of the graph is showing the full-step mode. And we can see that the current, and you can see on the left, there is this 1, 0, and -1, that the different coils are energized either in one orientation, which means like 1, or into the other orientation, which means -1. And by changing this current into the motor coils, that gives us those four steps in total when looking into a 360-degree movement. I mean, this is quite coarse, as we have seen it. And how can we improve that? This would be done by bringing another level into this orientation of the current that goes through the coil, which we see on the second half of this graph, by adding another level where we actually do not energize one of the coils at those different positions. We increase the positions from 4 to 8. And that means that the oscillation when jumping to one of those half-step positions is reduced. So the motion is actually smoother with less vibrations.
So Lars, are full steps and half steps our only option here?
No, so we can get one step further by having even more positions introduced with microstepping, which increases the accuracy. So if you think about a typical hybrid bipolar stepper motor, which typically has 200 full steps per revolution, we divide like every of those full steps into microsteps. When using half step, you have not 200 full steps, but 400 full steps per revolution. And the higher the microstep resolution is, the more accuracy you bring into the system by adding more positions. So, for example, with 256 microstepping, you would get from those 200 full steps in total 51,200 microsteps, which is quite a lot. This really helps to increase the torque of the control. With a stepper motor, you have typically two resonance frequencies, especially during acceleration. Going over those can actually cause vibration in the system, in worst case, step loss, which one definitely wants to avoid. And by having this high microstep resolution, these resonance spots are overcome. But on the other side, you increase the torque with the low velocity. So that's another big benefit. The efficiency by those factors are increased as well as we add advanced control with those microstepping into the stepper motor, which, if looking into half steps, seems pretty basic and simple. The smoothness is increased, as we have seen in the other slides. Spring mass systems brings the coils or the step rotors into oscillation, and with this microstepping, this oscillation disappears. So it reduces step loss by having better control of the stepper motor, especially during the acceleration and the resonance points. It reduces the vibration in the system and at the same time reduces noise, because if you think about this oscillations, this is actually something that you could hear, especially when adding the mechanical components of the system. And the smoother the motor runs, the less you can hear this oscillations, those vibrations, so it gets more silent.
So, what all is included in this microstepping solution?
What we see here is actually a pretty nice setup. So by adding a laser pointer on top of a stepper motor, having that pointed to a wall in a far distance, we can see here different modes operating a stepper motor. On the top, you can see the full step mode, where you can actually visually see it's jumping from one position to the other, full step position, and you get a feeling about also the oscillation. The 16 times microstepping is much smoother. You can see it, but still, if you really follow the red dot with your eyes, you can see it's some sort of pumping, so it's not a smooth motion. By adding even more microsteps, up to 256, as you can see it, and that's our patented current control chopper scheme spread cycle, the movement is extremely smooth. If you follow the red dot, you might still see a little bit of pumping, but it's reduced to a minimum. And our stealth chop technology is one step further. The accuracy and position accuracy we get with the 256 remains the same, but here we add another level of smoothness of the motion and also something regarding acoustic noise, which we come to the later stage.
So, Lars, what does this solution buy me as an engineer? Are there other benefits that your solution brings?
Absolutely. So when a motor is turning, it generates back EMF, and the faster the motor spins, the more back EMF is actually introduced into the system. What we're doing here is we are taking actually an advantage of that. So we have a technology where this back EMF measurement is used to determine the load angle that we internally kind of measure. So we get a feeling how much load is applied to the motor. If you imagine that you have a stepper motor that is turning and you apply load to the motor shaft, the load angle will change. From left to right, if we don't have any load on the motor shaft, the load angle is actually 0 degrees and the spare energy is high. If we apply load to a load angle of 45 degrees, the spare energy is medium. And as soon as we apply even more load, that we are close to a 90 degree load angle, we are close to a stall condition. And this is something that you want to avoid in a stepper motor system. If you lose steps, that means that you also lose the position and you won't actually lose track and the system is not in sync anymore. So that's something that you want to avoid.
So, Lars, load measurement is really valuable in this arena, right? What kind of load measurement solutions do you guys offer here?
Yeah, great question. This is our Stalguard feature. So what Stalguard is doing, it's in this open loop environment without having any additional feedback like a sensor or an encoder. We are using this back EMF and determine how much load is actually applied to the motor shaft or in the system. And what we see with this graph here, you can see the red line is our current. So this is like a graph over time. So the current is permanent at the same level, Let's say it's 1 amp for a 1.2 amp rated stepper motor. And the blue line is our load. So respectively, our stall guard readout. This is, by the way, all done within our solution. So you don't have to take care about that. It's just some tuning and it will show you essentially what we see here. When the motor is operating in the system as intended to, what we see is that the load at a certain time stays on a low level. And then for some reason, there is load applied in the system. There's any load condition. You can see that this load readout increases. So this is something that we get as feedback from this stall guard feature. As you can see, we have some sort of safety margin. Until this point, everything is being tolerated in the system and we don't have to worry. The good thing is that we have total control because we get this readout and get this feedback from our solution. So what we can set up as soon as we reach the 100% max load, that's kind of the critical point where you would lose position, where you get out of sync. And we can set up our stall guard technology that this stall or close to stall condition will be detected. And for example, you could stop the motor or interact to it. So the stall guard feature can be used for different ways. You can use it as a homing mode where you would detect the left hard stop, the right hard stop in your system when thinking about a linear system. You can use it as stall prevention, which is the main goal here, as the name says, right? Stall guard. So you want to guard the system from a stall. This is like the typical functions that we see in systems, essentially to get better control, better readout in an open loop system without adding any other components as it's integrated into our hardware solutions.
So Lars, is there something else that I could use the load measurement for?
Yes, that's exactly what CoolStep is made for. So CoolStep is taking this measurement. So StallGuard delivers you the feedback, how much load you have in the system, where CoolStep is taking this value and automatically and dynamically regulates the current that is going through the motor coils. If you look at this graph, you see that the load at the start is very low. So why should we have the current at the maximum, right? I just had this example where with a 1.2 amp motor, you apply 1 amp of current. And as here, we don't have any load on the motor, the current, for example, here could be 300 milliamps. And then when the motor load increases on the motor shaft, the motor current will automatically be increased. And then we have this second plateau where the load keeps at this level and the current also remains at this level. So we get the load and the torque from our motor that we need. When even more load is applied to the motor, we can see the current gets even higher. And one big benefit of CoolStep is that you can actually overboost the stepper motor. So think about this 1.2 amp motor example. What we could do here is actually we could apply even more current the motor is capable to handle for a short time. If we do that too long, the motor gets heaten up and we actually might damage the motor. But if we do that for a short time to actually get some extra boost out of the motor in respect for torque, we can do that. When the load is decreasing again, you can see that the current is following. So this makes CoolStep a very energy efficient feature and solution. And if you think about medical applications like peristaltic pump, where you deliver some sort of liquid, it's absolutely not tolerable to have like any heat in your system. And stepper motors can get quite warm. Using CoolStep, you only increase the current, respectively, generate heat in your system when needed, and then keep the current most of the time at a low level. That makes really a difference when looking into the temperature of the motor.
Lars, you mentioned Stealth Chop earlier. Can you explain that a bit further?
Sure. So Stealth Chop is one of our latest technologies when it comes to reducing audible noise in the system, but also have a smooth motor run. And what the difference here is, if you think about a current regulated chopper scheme, like our spread cycle technology, it always reacts to the coil current measurement on a cycle by cycle basis. This typically leads to noise and electric and magnetic coupling between both coils in the motor. And this leads on the other side to small variations of the resulting motor currents and thereby is influencing the current chopper. So the voltage regulated chopper scheme Stealth Chop modulates the current based on the PWM duty cycle. And the frequency is kept constant, which leads to minimizing of the current ripple. What we see here in the graph is that the y-axis is the current, or actually the PWM. So it's shown like those two values. The red one is the PWM. The blue one is the current. And the x-axis is showing the speed, so the velocity. What we can see is the higher the velocity gets, the higher this PWM output gets, by remaining the constant current of the stepper motor. The speed, like where we see this limit, PWM max, that's where the PWM is completely at full scale. And that's typically the point where the current drops by the motor itself, since it's running that fast, that the current is reduced. So that's caused by the back EMF generated by the motor. If you think about the back EMF, it's a voltage that it's generated by the motor speed, and it's facing to the other direction as the supply voltage. And when the back EMF is getting higher and higher, that's when the current starts to drop, and respectively, we would lose torque. The neat thing about our solutions is, because the stealth shot mode is for lower and medium velocity ranges, you can actually switch from one mode to the other.
All right. So, Lars, what kind of applications are you seeing this kind of technology being used in today?
Yeah, so there's a lot of different applications in the medical area. So if you think about a dialysis equipment, like a peristaltic pump, as already mentioned, there you have typically the challenge that the motor is getting warm, and that's something you want to avoid. So the perfect fit here would be CoolStep. With infusion pumps, we need high accuracy that can be achieved by microstepping and also our spread cycle and stealth shot modes. We see pipetting and analyzing, which is lab automation. So if you need like a fast, reliable system that, you know, needs to be durable just to make sure that you can have a high output, that's also where stepper motors and our solutions are being used. Other areas are 3D printing in the industrial area, but also consumer and CNC milling, any sort of desktop manufacturing systems. So if you think about a laser cutter, that's also where our technologies are used. When thinking about 3D printing and also CNC milling, if you need to find your homing spots, that's a great fit for our stall guard functionality, where you can just detect the hard stops by using this. And the other thing is obviously stealth chop. So wherever motors need to be noiseless, for example, could also be for a peristaltic pump. So any application or any device that's next to you that could generate noise will benefit from the stealth chop technology, essentially.
Cool. Now, what kind of solutions do you guys offer in this space?
Yeah, one of our solutions, which is a high runner, is the TMCM6110. This is like a board level product, like a six-axis module that goes per motor axis. So you can connect six motors in total, goes up to 1.1 amp RMS per channel on a very tiny space. So this module is quite small and goes up to 28 volts DC. It can be used in a standalone operation, so you can pretty much program it with our own proprietary motion control language called TMCL. But on the other side, when using the interfaces like RS-232, 485, USB or CAN, you can also change the parameters on the fly at the same time when using the standalone operation, or you just choose one of those two modes. You have several IOs and the stall guard 2 function, the cool step, and the spread cycle. If you want to move your motor, you can use a trapezoidal ramping mode. So that's related to getting to your target velocity and having the acceleration and deceleration. This is all handled by the module. If you don't need six axes, but for example, three or two, we have another solution that's off the shelf called the TMCM-3110. And this is a three-axis module. And as you can see already on the slide, it's for higher power output. So per channel, you get 2.8 amp RMS and up to 48 volts DC. Additionally, it offers incremental encoder inputs. So if you want to use encoders, you can connect them here. It wouldn't do the closed loop functionality for you, as it's more like for a position check. So you could automatically stop the motor if there's a certain deviation of the motor and the encoder. So that's the purpose of this incremental encoder input. And other than that, it comes pretty much with the same features as the 6110 and is used in a variety of applications.
So do you guys also offer an IC here in addition to the models you mentioned?
Yes. So the two modules mentioned are just examples, right? We have many more products in the board level area. The same with the ICs, but one IC I want to point out is the TMC2209, which is a single axis driver IC that integrates all of the solutions and features I mentioned today. The stall guard 4, cool step, stealth shot 2, micro plier, spread cycle, 256 micro stepping. So this IC enables all those advanced technologies provided by Trinamic and is used in a lot of different applications. So those are the products I wanted to mention today. But if you check, you know, you will find many more products that we offer. And all of our latest solutions actually come with our latest technologies as well.
Excellent. Well, Lars, I think that's all I have time for today. Thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you, Amelia. That was a great session.
And before we go, you didn't forget to click that link, did you? There you can find even more information about this topic. For Chalk Talks, I'm Amelia Dalton from eejournal.com. For more Chalk Talks, head on over to the Chalk Talks section of EE Journal. You can't miss it. It's right across the top. Or head on over to YouTube, youtube.com/EEJournal.